We hear conversations all the time about the state of the Trinidad and Tobago economy. I'm wondering if you speak about Tobago specifically. What's the state of play?
Yeah, well, what happened is that when you look at the economy of Tobago, over the number of years, the economy in Tobago has been in a bit of problem. For example, the same time last year, we would have had four sea vessels traveling between Trinidad and Tobago, two cargo vessels, two fast ferry. Right at this point in time, we only have one fast ferry, and then we only have one cargo vessel operating between Trinidad and Tobago, with some uncertainty as to what will happen with this existing cargo ferry. What we were informed, the government would have wanted, the operators would have wanted an 18-month contract. Now they had a month-to-month contract. So now, at any point in time, the lifeline between Trinidad and Tobago can be severed. The owners can pick up their boat and say, listen, we would like to have our boat. There's no really sustainable contract in place. We will pick up and go and leave Trinidad and Tobago. That will be catastrophic for the people of Tobago, right? Right now, we only have one fast ferry operating between Trinidad and Tobago. So we had a serious issue approximately two Sundays ago when all the flights that Kyle had between Trinidad and Tobago developed mechanical problem, and we had a serious problem that no aircraft between Trinidad and Tobago flew for approximately 4.5 to 5 hours. So, if you want to say business is good in Tobago, it is very, very, very problematic right now. And it is not looking good. We have the Christmas season coming up, and some businessmen actually asking themselves, what do we really actually do for the Christmas season coming up in Tobago, where business is concerned?
Now, you spoke of the fact that we've moved from two fast ferries and two cargo vessels to one of each. Going a little back in time, you denied that you won the wave night when it was blocking the cargo vessel trying to dock at Scarborough Port. But moving past, yes or no, right or wrong, what does that mean in dollars and cents, having to turn back the cargo vessel and come at another time?
All right, so we do the math. I never deny that I was not on the boat. What happened is that, let me clear that up one time for Trinidad and Tobago. We were invited to a reception by the British High Commissioner on the vessel. And we departed the vessel before the cargo vessel is due to dock in Tobago. So we had no idea as to the problem that cargo vessel would have had. So it was a simple mistake, but that again, the port did not manage that properly. If you look at dollars and cents, if the boat came back, you would have about approximately 120 trucks on that vessel. Each truck will carry approximately 50 to 70,000 dollars, depending on what they carry. So if you do the math, you have significant losses in terms of value to cargo and value to trade between Trinidad and Tobago. Because what we do, we buy all these goods from the manufacturing and producing sector in Trinidad. And if you have a disruption, just do the math. Each truck has approximately between $50,000 to $70,000 dollars of goods on it. And if you have 120 trucks moving through Trinidad and Tobago per day on that vessel, you have a serious, serious interruption in trade on that vessel. That is not something to be taken lightly. It's a serious livelihood of everybody. When that cargo vessel is interrupted, the cargo vessel has been parked up in Tobago for the weekend. Sunday and Monday, the vessel did not sail because there's a cruise ship in the port in Port of Spain. So now, every time you have a vessel in the port in Trinidad, trade is interrupted and literally stopped in Tobago. And we need to start to find some serious ways as how to sit down and deal with these issues.
In terms of looking at trade and the fact that trade is stymied when these things happen, How does that affect tourism, and what are we looking at when we say tourism in Tobago right now?
Well, we've been talking to the hotel association. If some properties literally complain that they are down to single digits, 9%, 8%, and that kind. This is the winter season. This is the height of your peak period. Some destinations, Grenada, Barbados, they are up to 80 to 90% in occupancy. Tobago is not doing well at all. The hotel association is complaining. Some one or two properties might be doing well because they would have targeted a specific market. So they are, but overall, the overall picture is not looking that good. Because you expect this is the creme of the creme time of the year. This is really and truly the winter season when you should be getting your bulk of business, but you are just not seeing it because we have a number of issues. The airport is not adequate. A number of airlines complain that the international arrival pace is not conducive to international arrivals. They've been complaining about that for years. And that is why you see a reduction in the arrivals in Tobago. You have people plan, if you're not making money, obviously you can't invest back into your property. So people are not able to bring back up their property, because if you were operating 90% a couple of years ago and you're operating to 10 to 9% now, seriously, you cannot invest that kind of money to bring back up your things. Then you talk about marketing the island. And even though we depended on the domestic market from Trinidad, here what happens. If a man and his family comes to Tobago and they are subjected to a 5-hour to a 4-hour delay on the airport, the next time they want to travel to their family and Trinidadians have the wherewithal to travel outside of Trinidad and Tobago, they will say, listen, I am going to Grenada, Barbados, St. Lucia, Miami, North America, because I can check in at 5 o'clock and I know I depart at 7 o'clock. Because that is the thing. There is no consistency in terms of the air bridge. And we've been complaining. I heard the chief secretary call out to the car board to look at Tobago as a specialty. But we've been talking about this for years. You understand? We need the situation to be fixed.
You spoke about marketing in two ways. One, how Tobago generally is marketed. You also said that some specific destinations or hoteliers on Tobago are doing much better than the average because they seem to have marketed to niches, specific niches. Is that does that kind of point the way forward for how it is we're supposed to kind of brand hotels in Tobago? Is there a niche that we're supposed to be going after with a very kind of concerted sort of manner?
Well, of course, because what you can do, and that is the problem that we have. We have articulated from the chamber point of view. What is this thing called tourism? What is the product that we are selling? Is it that we are selling fun? Everybody in the Caribbean have that. We are the last chain of islands in the Caribbean. So if a man leaves North America, he will go to Jamaica for that. If he leaves Europe, the first couple of he will go to Antigua for that. So we cannot compete. And remember, the mindset of people, and especially Tobagonian people, because the majority of people have been for years employed with the Tobago House of Assembly, they don't see a job in the tourism industry as their mainstay. You understand? What they see is a job in the tourism industry as a second job. And, well, if I don't need that. You understand? So that is what has hurt the tourism industry in Tobago in a big way throughout the years. What we have not had is a serious, serious policy from government as to how we're going to take this thing called tourism forward.
Just before we talk about policy and continue to talk about policy, rather, because I want to bring the topic of sandals into play, I'm wondering if there are any other mitigating factors such as sargassum. I'm not sure if the lionfish have actually touch Tobago waters as well, coastal erosions. How I'm looking at that, asking about that, as well as how do the local hoteliers view the impending arrival of sandals?
Well, the information we got is that in every crisis or even bad situation, you make good. If we have a landfish, explosion of landfish on the Tobago thing, because they're predatory fish, you should have massive marketing, hunting landfish. That could be a niche. You know, you might have divers coming to Tobago looking at just hunting landfish, and we have a big landfish festival. And we saw in Miami, had a landfish problem. And what they did is that they turned it around and encouraged people to hunt the landfish and have big festivals every weekend until the population of landfish went down to an acceptable level. You have not seen that sort of aggressive marketing in Tobago, right? Now you have this, the government has indicated clearly by the Prime Minister that they want to bring sandals into the market of Tobago. And that, from the business community, we say we need investment, we need serious investment. And it's the first time we have seen that the government is putting the policy to see that we are very much interested in the hotel and tourism sector. You have never heard that before, and we hope that we can keep the Prime Minister to his word, that not just sandals, we start looking at other serious brands to bring into the island of Tobago so we can move. Because I will tell you, the Tobago product is way better than a number of products throughout the island. But we are not given the serious policy decision to move the island forward, and that is the concept.
What are some of the possibilities of spin-off revenue with sandals being in train?
Well, we just returned the chamber. We mounted a team because we wanted to find out what is the significant benefit to the people of some of the islands that would have operated and had sandals. So we went to Grenada. The outlook is good because what we were told by the Grenada authority that they would have had four international flights weekly to Grenada. The government paid for two. Since sandals came into the market, they now operate 14 non-stop international flights without sharing with anybody else. The economy boomed throughout the past 2 years with sandals. They take a number of produce from the local people. All the tours are operated by local people. So from our experience and what we saw at Sandal, it seems like it's a good deal to have. Obviously, you will have to have the checks and balances to be put in place. The concern about the environment, the concern about equal share in terms of you don't have a mass importment of staff and workers to the island. So, again, it has to be done and done in a conservative way. But also the problem that you have in Tobago is that there's not a lot of information going out to the general public, so people go with speculation and hearsay. And the government team need to come out to the people and say, listen, this is what we plan for the island, or sandals need to come out and say, this is what we are planning. Because what you hear is hearsay, and people go on emotion when they do not have the correct information. Right? And we went to Grenada as the chamber to get a fact-finding mission, and we got the information. Information is, yes, when sandals, the biggest thing with sandals is airlift. Airlift, they are super in airlift. Wherever sandals go, the airlines go. We've been trying to call Delta and all these other North American airlines to come into Tobago. All of a sudden, sandals is coming to Tobago, and all these people are now calling us. How do we get into the Tobago market? So they bring a wealth of experience and knowledge in marketing and airlift, and that will trickle down to the other hoteliers. Because what we found out in Grenada is sandals would normally take 75% of the aircraft, and the other 55% of the aircraft will go to the other hotels and destinations. Passengers that you will not have before. And if the flights are non-stop from North America, so you know 100% of those people coming off on the aircraft staying at your destination. And that is something that we look forward to, and hopefully the game changer can change, turn around the economy of Tobago.